years ago, a man's fantasy became reality in a form never seen before. Kitchen Stadium, a giant cooking arena. The motivation for spending his fortune to create Kitchen Stadium was to encounter new original cuisines, which could be called true artistic creations.
I want a cheesy!
To realize his dream, he secretly started choosing the top chefs of various styles of cooking. And he named his men the Iron Chefs, the invincible men of culinary skills. Iron Chef Japanese is Masaharu Morimoto. Iron Chef French is Hiroyuki Sakai. Iron Chef Chinese is Chen Kenichi. And Masahiko Kobe is Iron Chef Italian. Kitchen Stadium is the arena where Iron Chefs await the challenges of master chefs from around the world. Both the Iron Chef and Challenger have 1 hour to tackle the theme ingredient of the day, using all their senses, skills, creativity. They're to prepare artistic dishes never tasted before. And if ever a Challenger wins over the Iron Chef, he or she will gain the people's ovation and fame forever. Every battle, reputations are on the line in Kitchen Stadium, where master chefs pit their artistic creations against each other. What inspiration does today's challenger bring? And how will the Iron Chef fight back? The heat will be on!
If memory serves me right, the almost predestined confrontation between the Ota faction and Morimoto entered the fifth battle last week. After winning his first in the fourth battle, Ota said that he plans to continue until he has a winning record. So, last week, he sent in his fifth man from Kyushu's Takeo Hot Springs, a conjurer with Japanese sake, Yusuke Yamashita. Meanwhile, Morimoto had lost two in a row before this battle. His pride as an Iron Chef was at stake. And the theme ingredient was cod roll. An everyday ingredient difficult to prepare for main dishes. And how did they do?
Fukuzan,
take it.
Yeah, I asked the challenger how important sake is to his style. He said Japanese sake is to cooking what a producer is to TV. The use of sake determines how well ingredients can be combined with both broth and seasonings.
Challenger Yamashita cleverly used Japanese sake in his five traditional dishes.
Yeah, I asked Iron Chef Morimoto about his losses, and he said, yeah, I've lost two in a row, and I'd be lying if I said I'm not concerned about it, but I'll never change my style, never. He sounded as confidently stubborn as ever.
Our Iron Chef Morimoto, as always, fully utilized his imagination to create five extraordinary dishes of pure originality. The fierce cod roll battle ended with the verdict of...
両者同点 よって延長戦!
Oh my! Tied! We are going to overtime! Judges deadlocked, the total points tied at 75. Just the fifth time in Iron Chef history we'll go to OT, so hang on! With a new theme ingredient, a 30-minute cook-off, that'll begin 5 minutes from now.
So, once again, squeeze whatever skills and imagination you have left and fight it out again.
すでに延長戦のテーマはこの中に入っています。それでは試合時間30分の延長戦に入ります。それでは発表します。延長戦のテーマはこれです。 나간냉이.
Time Iron Chef Morimoto trying desperately not to lose his third in a row while challenger Yamashita looking to put a devastating blow on the Iron Chef for the Ota faction. It's do or die time for both of them. And the opening gong for overtime bang, just the fifth overtime in Iron Chef history, and again the Ota faction boys re-energized, pounding of the taiko drum they brought in as the men are already making their way down the stairs from the ingredient stand, all loaded up with scallions, long onions here in Japan, and challenger Yamashita looking a little dazed here right at the outset of the 30-minute overtime cook-off. Only 30 minutes they'll have to prepare dishes worthy of tasting. Last overtime we had challenger Liang Shu King beat Iron Chef Chen, pork belly giving way to konnyaku in overtime. Go to
Iron Chef Monudo just couldn't believe that when he found out he was going into overtime, he's been mumbling ever since, I don't want to do this, I don't want to do this, I don't want to do this.
Better change that frame of mind. And in case you are wondering, yes, this is Morimoto's first excursion into overtime. A negative mindset can't help him. But I'm sure he'll get himself righted quick. And Doc?
Yeah.
Kadro now giving way to scallions and not much time for the men to switch gears.
Yeah, you're right about that. This really won't be easy for them. Probably the best ingredient combined with this would be duck meat,
right?
As far as Japanese mm-hmm. cuisine goes. It would be the easiest anyway. And also the kind of sauce that you use will also be a key factor in. So it's going to be interesting to see what they do.
Okay, well, maybe the traditionalist will have a slight edge. Yeah. Go ahead, Ota.
Yeah, I just heard that right after the Kadro battle, Morimoto had packed up all of his knives, etc., and now in the overtime, he has to start out by unpacking everything.
He was ready to leave.
What?
Oh. Well, anything can happen here. He should know that. And
for
he still looks a little lost. Take it.
Yeah, just as Hattori-san predicted, on the challenger side, they have rolled out the duck meat.
All right,
call
it.
Oh, yes, Yamashita with the duck meat. Quickly moving ahead with the golden combo.
And Fukui-san?
Go ahead.
One more thing, speaking of the challenger, he says, hey, I was certain that I won that Kadro battle, but it's okay because I'm going to win this one for sure.
All right, thanks, Ota. And Yamashita now appears to be back on track, fully engaged. We're just into the 30-minute overtime. And now let's reintroduce our guests for this overtime affair. First, singer Sachiko Kobayashi. Nice to have you.
Hello
still.
Again. This is my first time to witness this.
It's rare. We've been on 5.5 years, only the fifth time.
Yes.
About once a year.
Right, uh-huh.
But memorable.
Oh, really? I feel very honored.
Okay, and once again, actor Kunihiko Mitomura.
Hi, nice to be back.
Have to tell you, you two caused overtime. You had the same scores reversed. Kobayashi-san, you had it 20-19, the challenger, and Mitomura had it 20-19, Iron Chef.
Oh, really?
That's right, and Doc?
Yeah.
Take a look. Judges at 2-2 and total points 75-75.
Yeah, what a great battle that was.
They could not reach a decision on the victor.
Yeah, and you guys, what really was the difficulty with the judging there?
Well, personally, the key I'd have to say was whether you can identify the Iron Chef's dishes as Japanese cuisine or not.
Yeah, you're right. Actually, many people say that.
And hold on. Hey, Yamashita's not giving up on the sake yet. Go.
Yes, once again, the challenger is working his sake magic.
All right, the sake specialist sticking with what brought him here, more dishes using the best sake in the country.
And
coming our way, go ahead.
Iron Chef Morimoto just told me that one of his strategies for overtime is to creatively use some of the leftovers from the previous battle, starting with the boiled rice in his rice cooker.
He's got rice in the cooker.
Yes, he does.
All right, he's announcing he'll go with rice he prepared during the Kadro battle. A new theme for overtime, though, and it's scallions looking up close at them right there. And now we'll take a closer look at the scores in the Kadro battle. Kurimoto, 19-18 challenger. Kobayashi, 20-19 challenger. Two for Yamashita, but Mitomura, 20-19 Iron Chef. And Hosoki, 18-17 Iron Chef. Two for Morimoto. Total points tied at 75, bringing us just the fifth overtime in Kitchen Stadium history. Go!
Talking about scallions, Iron Chef Morimoto says, I think it's as good a time as any to rethink their potential because, to be honest, I don't like them. I don't even use them.
All right, could be having some difficulty in deciding just how he'll use him, but he seems to be a bit more into it now, and we see some duck meat here.
Okay, well, I noticed the challenger has pierced the scallions through the meat.
This is not sandwiched.
Well, kind of, but it pierced would be a more correct term, I believe. He'll probably grill it like this.
Okay, and the challenger quickly into the golden combo. Challenger side here. Slicing continues. Only 30 minutes, and you know it's just going to go like that in this battle. Go ahead.
I found another leftover that the Iron Chef is going to utilize. It's the broth that he used for the lobster and Kadro soup. He said that'll function as a flavoring for something else, obviously including scallions.
I can see that. Makes total sense.
All right, so Morimoto moving into a recycling mode. That'll help, not having to start completely from scratch. As we view on replay, his lobster and Kadro soup, and now back live, the Iron Chef stepping it up.
Yeah, well, I know both chefs didn't even think about this happening.
Well, no one ever does, really.
Yeah, and, you know, but each time in Kitchen Stadium, it's equipped with an ingredient for a possible overtime, right?
Right.
And they usually remain unused, but today the backup ingredients are being used, so scallions should feel quite honored, I believe.
Yes. Commenting on the combination of duck and scallions, challenger Yamashita says duck meat between scallions is the norm, so reversing that, scallions wrapped in duck meat should be okay.
Okay, duck meat and scallions, kamonegi in Japanese, so popular.
Loves it, yeah.
Going with the orthodox approach, take it.
The challenger actually has two kinds of meat that he's combining with scallions. This one is duck meat wrapped around the scallions that have already been grilled once. The other combo is using beef sirloin strips. Now, the scallions that he's using with the beef are raw. They have not been cooked in any way yet.
Okay, thanks for clarifying. It's duck meat and beef, two kinds of meat in different combinations with scallions. While they are orthodox, the approaches are rather intricate.
Yeah, you could actually call them negima in Japanese cooking.
Okay, take it again, Ota.
Yeah, Iron Chef Morimoto said he was intending to include duck meat himself, but after hearing that the challenger was using it, he's flatly rejected going in the same direction. He says he'll try something else. He wants to be completely unique.
No, he's holding his ground. I admire someone who does that.
Well, earlier he followed Yamashita's lead, right? Ochazuke. Okay, yes, Ota.
Back on the challenger side, his steamer contains snapper fillets.
What's that over there, snapper?
Right here in the steam. Yes, right here in the steamer.
Okay, getting the steam treatment, and by my count, that's at least three dishes so far for the challenger.
Outstanding.
And they are happy about that upstairs. Faction leader Ota, advisor Kanagawa, the rest of them hoping their man Yamashita can deliver the coup de grace.
Fukui-san.
Yes.
I asked challenger Yamashita whether or not he was going to use leftovers from the Kaduro battle, and he replied, leftovers? Are you kidding? I'm not that cheap. This is a different battle, so all dishes should be created fresh, from scratch, from the beginning.
Well, what he says does make sense.
Yusuke Yamashita still wearing his warrior's kamikaze headband, game face on. The characters on the headband read, true flavor.
Fukui-san.
Go.
While the Iron Chef was slicing his foie gras, he was still mumbling, will the tasters even be able to eat anymore? Foie gras could be too heavy, we'll just have to see.
Has to consider that.
I am full, but I can't pass up this great opportunity.
Well, how much more food can you take right now? Are you still full?
Me too.
I'm quite full, really. I finished most of the dishes.
Okay, might be wise to go with lighter dishes then.
Well, scallion dishes will be lighter naturally.
6 to 7 dishes.
Croissant?
Yes.
Yeah, in this deep frying pan, the Iron Chef has blended garlic, ginger, tochi bean paste, red bell peppers, Chinese rice wine, soy sauce, salt, sugar, water, and cornstarch.
Okay, and that right there, the makings of something spicy by Iron Chef Morimoto.
Sounds almost Chinese, doesn't it? Yes.
Yeah, I told the Iron Chef that the challenger had called using leftovers cheap, and he just grinned and said, hey, my policy is to be environmentally friendly, not wasteful.
All right, thanks.
Both these guys are really letting their feelings out.
Both making their arguments.
I can see that.
20 minutes.
And now 20 minutes left, 10 minutes gone, and OT.
Already? Wow, so
this
fast.
This one is whizzing right by.
It'll be over in no time.
Now, how about this? Look, don't you think Yamashita's scallions are a little overcooked?
Yeah, I agree.
I mean, that top one is almost charred beyond recognition.
Maybe he'll only be using the insides of it. I'm not sure, but that could be the plan here.
All right.
Is the duck meat done all the way to the inside?
Don't know about that, but now Ota's upstairs with Kanagawa for a few words. Take it, big fella.
All right, thank you, Kanagawa-san. It's a do-or-die overtime.
Yeah,
how does it look to you?
Well, it's hard to tell who's going to win at this point, but I want our challenger to rip Morimoto apart, just like he's ripping apart those scallions.
Okay.
I'm ready to see that. I'm hoping to see that happen. I want to see him cry.
So you still have confidence?
Yeah, more than ever.
Any words of encouragement?
Yamashita! Go for it! Never give up!
All right, thank you. And Fukui-san, with that, we'll send it back to you.
Whoa! All right, thanks, Ota. As usual, Kanagawa, the trigger man for firing up the faction. Many of you might be wondering, can he cook? Is he more than just a loud heckler? The answer is yes, and we're hoping one of these days he'll battle in here. And now a very strong-looking broth here on Yamashita's side.
Yeah, very powerful-looking.
Fukui-san!
That is.
Go ahead, Ota.
This pot that the challenger is working on contains a blend of Worcester sauce, ketchup, sugar, and white wine.
All right, with Worcestershire sauce there.
Sounds quite strong.
Should be.
Your sauce, ketchup, and sugar?
What? I see two pots there. Now, they both contain the same ingredients? Doc, well, what's that all about over there? They do look a little different, though.
Yeah, I'm not too sure.
Yeah, when I hear Worcestershire sauce, ketchup, and sugar, I think of a thick sauce for a meatloaf or something like that.
Yeah, like easy cooking at home.
I don't think he's going to make something like that.
No, not what's made at home. Go.
I happened to mention to the challenger that his scallions wrapped in duck looked a little overdone, and he said, hey, this is what I wanted. It's perfect. You just wait and see what I do with it after this.
All right. Well, he has cleaned it up, scraping away the charred surface, and Yamashita battling
calling on behalf of the Ota faction, the head chef at a quality ryokan in Takeo Hot Springs, Saga Prefecture. He's here as the sake specialist. He proved that in the earlier battle. And now the faction's fifth hitman finds himself locked up in overtime with Morimoto.
It looks like Cantonese cuisine, doesn't it?
This is the Iron Chef.
Spicy, perhaps.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, is that tochi in there?
Yes, and some scallions and scallops.
Mm-hmm.
Fukui-san?
Yes.
Scallions go well with scallops?
Absolutely.
Go ahead, Ota.
Fukui-san? Yeah, sorry to interrupt. Right now you see the Iron Chef putting scallops into the steamer. Let me give you the ingredients to the sauce again. Scallions, garlic, ginger, tochi, bean paste, red bell peppers, Chinese rice wine, soy sauce, salt, sugar, water, oyster sauce, sesame seed oil, and cornstarch.
Wow, what a list of ingredients and a touch of Chinese flavor.
Yeah, very Chinese.
Yes.
And now this dish is in the steamer. It looks great right there. But how long will they need to cook this one? I mean, we've got exactly about 17 minutes left in OT.
Yeah, the clock is ticking.
Oh, that's lots of time for this.
That'll be okay?
Yeah.
All right.
Snapper, it's a snapper.
Oh yeah, right, the snapper.
This is on the challenger side. Replay here. Some shredded scallions have been sprinkled over the two pieces of snapper.
Now, we saw him making two kinds of sauce,
so
right?
It was two.
Yeah, so the one with the starch in should probably go with the snapper,
uh-huh.
I think.
Oh. Yeah, it goes inside.
Uh-huh. Okay, well, wait a minute. He's stewing them together now. What's this?
Well, he's been quick, Yamashita, so far in the extra session.
Yeah, same thing.
The
exactly.
challenger already has at least three dishes well underway. A little less than 15 minutes, three.
Fukui-san.
Yes?
I just got some comments from Tadamichi Ota in the Royal Box who says, I can't keep up with what's going on. Yamashita, you've come this far. Don't lose. Don't let me down. He's feeling the pressure.
Mm-hmm. All right, and there is the faction leader. Once again, no relation to our reporter, Ota. Maybe he sounded frustrated, but right there, didn't look that way. And now both men beginning to quicken their movements as we're nearing the halfway point of OT. Morimoto working with smaller pieces of scallions, apparently game planning smaller portions, taking into account the full stomachs of the tasters.
Yeah, and you'll notice that most of them are light taste as well.
Go.
In the pot that we were just looking at, if we can get back to it, yes, this one, the Iron Chef has the lobster broth with scallions out of the salamander oven.
Okay.
You'll remember that this lobster broth was left over from the previous battle.
Go with the broth. I'm with Morimoto here, and 15 minutes gone, 15 to go, halfway through OT, and you guessed it. That's the prompt for the war drum to get another workout. The challenger on his way to preparing heavier, meatier dishes than the Iron Chef with duck and beef.
Right, yeah.
But here they are on the challenger side with some smaller pieces, chopped up very small right there of the theme ingredient and put into the broth on low boil.
Yeah, I think this contains broth and Japanese sake.
Go ahead, Ota.
He hasn't added sake to this yet.
Oh, okay, not yet, I see.
Actually, it's bonito broth and consomme blended together along with the blackened grilled scallions.
Oh, okay. With only 30 minutes in OT, now the chefs are scurrying at this point.
Yes, you're right, which makes it fun for us to watch.
Yes.
I'm enjoying this, but I know it's hard for them.
The challenger, you said he's using consomme?
Memory serves me right, yes.
Previously, he's used Worcestershire sauce and ketchup?
Right, Western flavors for the challenger.
He's getting a little like Morimoto's in terms of his approach.
Quite a contrast.
Well, I guess he's turning Iron Chef Japanese. Their approaches are somewhat reversed from what we saw when they were tangled up in Kadro, and now here on the Iron Chef side, little pieces with this one getting ready, it looks like, yes, for a deep-fried job, scallion pieces on skewers.
Yeah, it looks like a good idea, doesn't it?
Fukui-san,
go.
What's being fried here is the batter. This is simply made of flour, eggs, and water, nothing more, here on the Iron Chef side.
All right, right here.
Right.
I can't keep my eyes off that clock, just ticking away.
Now less than 13 minutes.
All right, talk about pressure, but they are pulling it off.
They're doing it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is where their real skill shows up.
Mm. And it looks like Morimoto's got one done here.
Oh
yeah. Uh-huh.
This is a Chinese flavor.
Looks very good. You can handle this?
Oh, yes.
Absolutely. And just zooming in makes you hungry again. Go ahead, do some exercises.
Should I sing something?
Go for it.
Okay. From my new single, Yancha Zake. Okay, I'll stop.
Fukui-san.
Yes, Ota.
I've got more on the ingredients in the challenger's pot, which contains bonito broth, consomme, kuzu starch, and scallions. Now, you remember he added the chopped black scallions to the other bonito broth and consomme mix, right? Well, this is the same soup base, but now he's added soy sauce to it.
All right.
Oh, okay.
And that one getting double duty, and it's amazing how fast he came up with
he's
a new combo.
So well trained, obviously.
Yamashita's skill level quite high. And hey,
this one looks so good.
Iron Chef now, he's finished another one. Deep fried scallions.
Just tempura?
Looks just like it. Go.
About this sauce that you're seeing on the Iron Chef side, this is a mix of oyster sauce, water, and sugar that he's blended together and poured over the fried scallions. Back to you.
Okay, so the sauces he's prepared, mostly Chinese style.
style.
Right.
And here are the scallops steamed with a bit of a spicy Chinese sauce around them.
I think he'll pour oil over top of this.
Really heated oil.
That'll make it sizzle.
All right, 10 minutes left.
Already?
It's crunch time now. The last 10 minutes, the decisive stretch. Can the chefs make it on time in this overtime battle? Morimoto's completed two. Yamashita's got one, maybe two done. And here, yes, the challenger side starting to fry up some sliced beef.
He's cooking.
Tasters will have heavier dishes first. Could be fully stuffed by the time Morimoto's dishes are served. I'm thinking perhaps the Iron Chef might be at a disadvantage, and maybe Yamashita's deliberately employing a strategy of going with the heavier dishes to sate the appetites and lessen the impact of Morimoto's dishes. We'll see how it goes.
No.
Morimoto with more scallions now.
So Morimoto has two or three dishes.
Yes, and right now working on his third, apparently. Okay. He's got the scallops, scallions dish one.
Oh, right, the fried ones. Okay.
And yes, the deep fried scallions, almost tempura style, that's two. And then this one.
Okay, right, this one here.
Maybe a soup?
Boy. He just added foie gras, right?
Into soup with foie gras in it.
So a scallion soup, I guess.
Oh.
Okay, so there are three dishes on the Iron Chef side so far in the last third of the battle, and the challenger has three by my count, but all of his are heavier. And here is his snapper dish. This one, steamed snapper with scallions. No other flavorings have been added as of yet.
No, it's just steamed, I think.
All right, that's right, with scallions on top. Most likely he'll be pouring something over this one for flavoring.
Yeah, I would guess a sweet and sour type of sauce.
Yes.
About this steamed snapper, it has been flavored, but only lightly with sake.
Oh, sake, okay.
Right, can't forget that.
Well, that'd give it a really nice aroma.
And there is a layer of shredded scallions on top and some fresh ones just added to it. Sake-flavored steamed snapper. And now on the challenger side, here's the beef. Moments ago, he began stir-frying this one.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah. So this was just stir-fried,
simply
right?
Stir-fried with a thick sauce there.
Okay.
Fukui-san?
Go ahead.
I just happen to have the ingredients for this meat dish on the challenger side right here with me. It's being flavored with a mix of Japanese sake, brand name Mado no Ume, sweet cooking sake, soy sauce, grated regular onions, not scallions, and kudzu starch.
Mmm, great sauce. And now the Iron Chef here.
Oh, it's Chohan.
Yes, right. fried rice. Fried rice with scallions coming.
Maybe Chohan.
Using the rice left over from the cod roe battle, making fried rice go.
I asked Iron Chef Morimoto how his dishes are coming along, and he mumbled, "You know, I wouldn't even have to do this if the tasters have made up their mind in the first place. I know, I just like to complain."
Any comments?
Morimoto-san.
You don't hear Morimoto talk like this. A little out of character for the Iron Chef Japanese. And now the challenger side, Yamashita, with a boiled dish here to enjoy the soft texture of scallions.
Fukui-san, this has yams in it.
Oh, okay, yams.
Okay.
You know, speaking of scallions, people in Kyoto use them a lot in okonomiyaki.
Yeah, you're right. The greener ones. Yeah, I've seen that.
And that has become popular down Kyoto way.
Mm-hmm. I've had it once myself.
And looks like the Iron Chef now has four dishes. This soup he's working on, the scallop, scallion, tempura, and fried rice, a grand total of four. Pretty good for overtime.
Yeah. So impressive.
And now the challenger's duck scallion combo.
Fukui-san,
go ahead, Ota.
I tried to ask Challenger Yamashita about sake and scallions, but he said, "I don't know what you just asked me. I don't even know what I'm doing. More importantly, how much time have I got left?"
All right, I guess he's just got it on Auto Chef, huh? We have 6.5 minutes left. That's it.
Fukui-san?
Go again.
The ingredients in the Iron Chef has added to his fried rice so far are scallions, oil, and eggs.
Okay, flipping, flopping that one. Fried rice, simple but
and
nice.
Fukui-san?
Yes?
Sorry, I tried to find out how many dishes the Iron Chef was shooting for, but he just said, "I don't know. Come back when I'm done."
All right, Ota, tread lightly over there. He's in an irritable mood near the end of OT. And the fried rice is ready now. And Doc, you and I didn't get to taste anything earlier. Are you like me? I tell you, my stomach is beginning to growl.
Yeah, I agree with you. And you know, when you're talking about the judging earlier, I think one of the keys is going to be to see how the chefs have used the scallions in the dishes, you know, like the volume and things.
And so the appeal of the scallions in each dish.
Right, exactly.
That'll be key.
It suits the mood, right.
Okay.
Fukui-san.
Less than 5 minutes, go.
Yeah, I asked the challenger how many dishes he'll have, and he answered, "Four dishes, can I do four dishes? I think I have to do four dishes, I have to, I must." He sounded really pressed for time.
All right, take your word for it, four dishes. Seems like both will be evenly matched with four.
Interesting.
The Iron Chef's now poured some soup into his fried rice.
Sour sauce,
really?
I think.
Oh.
It should be a really nice treat.
So something akin to a rice porridge with this dish.
Yeah.
Very appetizing, and perhaps trying to take it easy on the stomachs of the tasters. They'll be quite full when it's time for his dishes to be before them. And Michimoto-san, these guys are something else. Both of them almost finished.
Incredible. In just 30 minutes, and they're able to make all this.
Okay, now what is this?
It's just incredible.
Yeah, absolutely.
All pro performances.
Talk about high caliber.
And, you know, think back. When overtime started, both seemed to be dazed and confused, but quickly they got their mojo going, found their footing, and they're nearly finished. Four dishes in 30 minutes with a little less than 4 minutes to spare. Simply amazing the job these two have done in overtime. Iron Chef Morimoto, challenger for the Ota faction, Challenger Yamashita.
Fukuzan.
Yes?
I managed to mention to the Iron Chef that since he made rice and tea in the Kadro battle, his fried rice doesn't seem to be very creative, and he kindly replied, mind your own business.
Oh, it's better not to go near him.
I tried to warn him, but Ota's going to do his job. I know my man. Yeah, He'll go back and try another opening gambit with the Iron Chef. And we are winding down, 3 minutes, 20 seconds and counting, and some flames there shooting up from under that pot on the stove on the Iron Chef's side. The broth that's inside. Now, where does this end up, Doc?
Okay, now the soup that we saw, the one with the foie gras and scallions, I think is what's happening here.
Okay.
Cousin?
Yes?
In the pot that you're looking at right now, the Iron Chef has both broth, salt, sweet cooking sake, and soy sauce.
All right, got that info from the Iron Chef. Thanks, Ota. Now less than 3 minutes remaining, and both men beginning to slow their pace as we near the finish. They're pretty much where they need to be, and they'll come in on time. For all intents and purposes, doesn't appear that fatigue has been a factor at all in overtime, the extra cook-off session. Especially Yamashita, he's handled it with ease.
Yeah, and when you look at the outcome of all the dishes, it looks like they had one full hour here, doesn't it?
It's amazing. Just amazing.
Fukuzan!
What do you have?
Yeah, the Snapper's Challenger, or the Challenger Snapper, you know what I mean.
Yeah.
This includes bonito broth, consomme, kudzu starch, scallion, soy sauce, salt, wakame seaweed, and bamboo shoots all stewed together. I'm talking, of course, about the garnishing on top.
Okay, and from the color of the sauce, yes, we can see it does contain soy sauce in it. There's the flavoring, and now here is Morimoto soup.
Oh, yeah, the soup. There we go.
Foie gras and scallion soup looks wonderful, and just out of camera range is the fried rice in a sauce dish. He has a total of four dishes, the soup, rice, scallops, and fried scallions. He prepared and completed these four dishes in less than 30 minutes. Unbelievable.
Amazing. These guys are
and now,
amazing.
Here is an overview, a scan of Morimoto's dishes.
Cousin.
Yes?
The soup that the Iron Chef just poured over the foie gras and grilled scallions, as we get a closer look up at here, this soup, once again, is made from bonito broth, salt, sweet cooking sake, and soy sauce.
All right, good job, thanks. And so, after the cod roe dishes, you two get to enjoy scallion dishes today.
I'm certainly ready.
You know, scallions are...
He's pouring
hot oil.
Yeah. Right over the scallions, resting on scallops.
Scallions are usually not the main focus in a dish, so how well they've combined them with other ingredients, that's the key.
How they match.
You're right. But, you know, in my opinion, it's the volume of the theme ingredient of the scallions is also going to be key to the judgment.
Yes.
Right in front of the Iron Chef, he has some cups with fried rice in them that he just poured soup into. That soup is made from the lobster and cod roe broth from the other battle.
Right.
And now he's topping it with scallions grilled in the oven.
Well, this looks good, too. And if I could, I'd dip in right now. We didn't taste, Doc and I. Everything looks great.
Exactly. It certainly does.
All right, a minute to go. The final 60 seconds of overtime.
Fukuzan.
Yes.
I asked the challenger one last time if he'll be able to finish his four dishes, and he said, look at him, they're ready. I just have to tweak them a little bit, but I see the goal. I smell a victory. He's confident.
All right, just taking it to overtime was an accomplishment in its own right, but they're here to win, the Ota faction. Yamashita, the sake specialist, trying to secure the faction's second straight win over their nemesis, his wife. She's watched nervously all the proceedings today. First a 60-minute battle ending in a tie, and now 30 minutes more of a grueling overtime duel with the Iron Chef. Less than 30 seconds now. The challenger, a look of determination on his face, giving a last bath of sauce to his duck and scallion creation. The Iron Chef desperate to avoid a humiliating third straight loss. No Iron Chef has ever dropped three in a row. Serious consequences could result. Morimoto doesn't even want to contemplate them, but the Ota faction would relish the opportunity to send the Iron Chef reeling, and thus the stakes are enormous for the outcome of this overtime battle. The final seconds are ticking down. It's gone so fast. The cooking almost done, and that's it. The overtime scallion battle is over.
Nice job in there.
Oh, thanks.
Overtime. How was it?
It was tough.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You said you thought you had the battle won. Then you ended up going into overtime.
Yeah.
That
yeah.
must have been an unexpected shock. Yeah. Did that affect your dishes?
Well, the flavor was perfect, so I think I can win.
So you're still confident?
Yeah, I can win.
Okay.
Yeah.
This is a must win against the Ota faction. Plus the champion, the Iron Chef, is expected to step up in overtime. That must have been tremendous pressure on you for 30 minutes.
Personally, that didn't bother me, but man, 30 minutes is so short.
Oh, yeah.
From Ali Cuisine to the gong was about 2 minutes to me.
So in that short time frame, how do you feel your dishes turned out?
I'm not sure. I just hustled all the way through.
Really?
Yeah.
Now, I know you feel that you have to have this one. Are you confident?
Well, I'd appreciate a win.
Okay.
Challenger Yamashita has four dishes. First, snapper steamed in sake with scallions. The slight bitterness of rape blossoms and the natural flavor of snapper are packaged in a subtle manner with scallions, texture of which sharpens the experience. Second, duck meat and scallion sauté. He created a savory aroma by initially charring the scallions. The thick sauce, using ketchup, finds a wonderful rapport with the duck meat. Yam and scallion soup. The natural texture of yams and the crispiness of scallions are blended in the bonito broth, where the sweetness of scallions emerges. It's truly an impressive dish for enjoying the inherent sweetness of scallions. Last, beef with scallion sauce. He used sake as the base for the sauce, a perfect platform for fusing scallions with the beef. Iron Chef Morimoto counters with his four. First, fried scallion, a simple dish depending solely on the natural flavor of the scallions. It's oyster sauce that adds depth and body to the flavor. Second, scallion soup with foie gras. The lobster and cod roe broth from the earlier battle finds harmony with the foie gras. With the aroma of scallions, this has turned out to be a supreme soup. Third, scallions and scallops, a steamed dish with the Chinese flavor. It lets scallions absorb the flavor of scallops. Heated oil poured on at the end adds a savory finish. Last, fried rice with scallions. Scallions mixed in the rice as well as the soup poured into it. The strong-bodied soup and subtly flavored rice make an intriguing duo. And now, the moment of truth, tasting and judgment for the overtime. Once again, on the panel are Lower House member Shinichiro Kurimoto, singer Sachiko Kobayashi, actor Kunihiko Mitomura, and fortune teller Kazuko Hosoki. First, the dishes of Challenger Yamashita. Yamashita will begin by serving his snapper steamed in sake.
I would like you to enjoy the aroma of the scallions with the snapper and with the broth.
The scallions in this dish are critical to the balance of the whole dish, so I agree.
The scallions are totally the star in this dish.
Yeah, a job well done. It's so great. The flavor is light, yet it's quite profound. This is great.
Yeah.
I'm impressed. In such a short time, you made such a good sauce. It's simply amazing. In only 30 minutes, I don't believe it.
The sauce to me is just a bit too sweet. The duck meat and the scallions are both good, but due to the time limitation, I think they really haven't blended together as much as, well, as they should have.
This is a yam and scallion soup to refresh your taste buds.
After drinking alcohol, well, you sometimes feel like having a light soup. This is so good for a time like that, with the grilled scallions, it's really very nice, I'd say.
Scallions are sweet. Yeah, they are sweet when cooked.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I like this.
The scallions are accentuated, and the dish alone is all right. But I think because the previous dish was heavy and had strong flavor, that this is almost too light. But I like it.
Now for this sauce, I put scallions to make a very Japanese-style sauce.
Uh-huh.
The scallions are just minced as a sort of garnish, I think. The flavor is good, but the scallions are just a supporting actor.
It's a fine dish, and I liked it a lot, but within the context of the show, I'm not sure if this dish has any impact at all.
Compared with the previous battle, some of your dishes from the overtime ended up less fine-tuned. It might have been better to have two perfect dishes than having four. The fine-tuning was missing in some dishes. Hope that doesn't sound too arrogant.
Now up, the dishes of Iron Chef Morimoto.
Well, you folks have had more than 10 dishes so far, so I avoided the thick flavoring. Another thing I kept in mind was to let the scallions be the main element.
It may just be a scallion, but this one is noble, so good. It speaks of what scallions really are. I love this dish very much.
It looked like just plain old tempura before we ate it. But it sure is a great dish just by itself.
I wanted to make a consommé, but I didn't have time. So this is based on bonito and kelp broth, and it has foie gras.
Mm. This is so good.
So
this is
great.
You sense a nice aroma of the foie gras, and the scallions are so tender, yet just a bit chewy.
Mm-hmm.
It's sweet and great, really. This is a fantastic dish.
By pouring heated oil over shredded scallions, I think you can accentuate the sweetness of the scallions even more.
You scallions must be happy today, being the star. Usually you're just the garnish.
The scallops have a sweetness to them, and so do the scallions, and that's why the spiciness is working in this. It's so good.
The scallions you used in this.
Yes.
They give a spice impact to the flavor. This is the best scallop dish I've ever had. I really enjoyed this one.
Everyone looks so full, and overdoing things is not good, so I better stop right here.
I'd like to try that now that you said that.
Well, make up your mind.
Oh, go ahead and serve it. You made it for us, right?
You're not saying you don't have confidence, do you?
A change of strategy on a whim. Is it a risk?
The fried rice with the sweet and sour flavor... It's a unique flavor, and it's quite good, and some might say it's a bit too sweet.
I like this.
It's very unusual.
It's maybe a bit too
sweet. But I liked it.
You prepared the sweet and sour sauce very nicely. It's a wonderful dish. I enjoyed it very much.
The overtime battle was so exciting. We really felt the tension of the two chefs. And here we re-experienced the excitement through the food and the dishes. It was a wonderful experience.
この 30分の死闘には危機迫るものさえありました。素晴らしい戦いだったと思います。それでは発表します。
Just the fifth overtime in Iron Chef history with so much hanging on the outcome. Challenger Yamashita battling with a sense of urgency to capture a second straight win for the Ota faction. After 90 minutes of battle, he's got Iron Chef Morimoto on the verge of a possible third straight loss, a blow no Iron Chef's pride could accept. Can Morimoto hold him off? Who takes it? Whose cuisine reigns supreme?
Tetsujin Morimoto Masaharu!
Morimoto! It's the Iron Chef! Oh my! He survives this overtime battle! And boy, did he show his emotions when the verdict was announced. Through a grueling 90 minutes of the best the Ota faction could throw at him, Yamashita taking it to overtime, but unable to finish off the Iron Chef in OT. All right, we've got to check these scores. Kurimoto, 20-17 Iron Chef. Kobayashi, 20-19 Iron Chef. Mitomura, 19-17 Iron Chef. Hosoki, 17-16 the challenger. 3-1 in favor of Iron Chef Morimoto in overtime, staving off a third straight defeat and back on track. The sweetness of scallions giving way to the sweet taste of victory and perhaps his biggest win ever, Iron Chef Japanese Masaharu Morimoto.
I felt the Iron Chef did better in accentuating the natural flavor of the scallions. It was the first time for me to have dishes in which scallions are not simply a garnish.
Iron Chef did well in creating dishes, modern dishes, based on his quick imagination and instincts. But I voted for the challenger who tried to do more intricate things with the ingredient.
Oh, it's too bad. Next time I'll bring one who has stamina.
It was a great match, really. A battle to be engraved in history. So today I'm simply moved and happy. That's all.